Hi, my name is Steve Kinney. I'm the head of front-end engineering at Temporal, and this is a course on React and TypeScript. Using React with TypeScript allows you to quickly and easily type your components, make sure you have the properties you're expecting. It allows you to quickly and easily find errors and bugs without even leaving your editor. In this course, you'll learn how to use the editor to find the types of various different React components and their properties inside of Visual Studio Code. You'll learn how to use the context API, React hooks, as well as type props in your React applications. I hope you enjoy the course.
So like right now we have a problem, which is theoretically we don't know what a quote is yet, right? And like this is an easy fix, but like this is where like let TypeScript handle everything for you. It's really good about that until it does not have enough information. That's usually the only times that you need to step in, because you're like, yo, use state. It's like quote is, you know, undefined. Right, and it thinks that it will forever be undefined. It's like, cool, you can only set, quote is undefined, and you can only set quote to undefined. Not great. And then like, I think even if I tried to use quote down here, it's like, we do catches. Like, it is a constant of undefined. You almost always get the loading situation here. So what we need to do is figure out like if we tried to like take the solution that we had before, like if I look at the quote type, I can see it has, an ID, content, and a source. Really, I need the content and the source to make this work. And so like one solution, and honestly, depending on your use case, which is not a terrible solution, which would be to like give it what I call like an empty value in this case. And then like maybe you have a skeleton loader and you get the right shape of everything. If you can pull it off with whatever you're working on, like this does have some problems, which is now like this won't work because like technically this is an object that exists. Also, it's like this is not prepared to have an ID because it's trying to guess it from the type. There's lots of like other edge cases. Let's talk about the more generic one where it's like the data might have, you know, one of a few different shapes or more than you have, like more than you can just fake out in the very beginning or to the point where it's not worth it. So in this case, we basically just need to say, kind of like when we used the question mark before to say like, this is either this value or it's undefined. We've seen this syntax and this, you know, if you've used TypeScript before, you've definitely seen it, but you know, I made promises that if you hadn't used it, you should be able to join with us. We can say basically pass it a generic or a type argument to what this should be. Like it is trying to guess, but in the event that it cannot guess correctly because it does not have enough information, we can basically say like, okay, this is a quote or it's undefined. Right. So now these are now it has figured it all out for us, right? We just had to give it a little bit of a helping hand to get it all the way there. And this will theoretically work for us in this case. So now this one will fetch a quote when it finally runs. And you'll notice that like if I took this out, because it's commented out, and the JavaScript will still run if you don't have a compile error. So like it's why you saw just an empty screen if you just spun up the app. And the loading indicator didn't stay there forever. Because like the JavaScript was running. It was just a TypeScript issue that we had at that point. But now it knows that it can be one or the other. We can actually pull this in. What's really cool about this that I kind of want to point out in this situation, which is up here, quote is quote or undefined, right? Let's just, I don't know, console log a quote, and then Mark can remind me to take it out. It's quote or undefined, right? Here we're saying, oh, it's quote or undefined. But if there's no quote, return. And not only does TypeScript like check the actual types in the type system, but it's also kind of like analyzing your code, right? And this is like a dead end. In the event that quote is undefined, right, it's falsy, we return. That means this code path stops here, right? This branch timeline like ends, right? It's been, what, pruned? Is that the term of art? And so like this, no, at this point forward, if quote exists at all, it can't be undefined anymore. right? So you no longer have to deal with the fact that it could be a quote or could be undefined, because the world in which it was undefined ended on line 29, right? You can just kind of move along, and it's like, it has already analyzed your code. It has figured it out for you. So it's one of those things, if you find yourself doing all these extra checks, like, you could hover over it. Like, if I somebody had put an if or like quote and to make sure it exists, right? I can hover over and see, like, was this code necessary, right? And get a sense of, like, is this actually quote or undefined, or is it now definitely a quote because I've done something, right, to confirm it one way or the other. You know, you have template literals in JavaScript, right? So you can do like, and then you do, and you put a variable in there, right? So TypeScript added this super powerful thing, which is the ability to do that with your type definitions. So I could say type, and this is still somewhat limited. I long for a day where this is better. And this is way better than when I did this course last time. So like, I can, like, my longing is not from nowhere, right? So I could say that it's a string that starts with a hash code, with a hash tag, right? And now this will only accept strings that start with that, which if they use it in their type system for this library, granted, this is a, like, relatively new TypeScript feature, yeah, it's not totally safe to use yet. For libraries, for your own code, totally safe to use. What TypeScript added in 4.6 or 4.7 was, it used to be you could only put other string types in there. The crazy thing that, and this is the thing that I use in my code as well, is, so if we want to say like RGB string, like the one that like CSS respects, brand new in like the last few months is the ability to do like something like this, RGB, and we could do number in here, right? Now, the only problem is we know that RGBs are supposed to be like maxed out at 255. Like, you can't do a number range or anything like that. But you could make, okay, now it has to be a string that matches like this general pattern, which is, yeah, like new-ish, right? And this is, yeah, not true of last time we did this workshop. And it's super powerful as well. And yes, at one point, did I try to make a union type of 0 through 9, A, B, C, D, E, F, hashtag, and then six of those, I did try to do that. The like number of like type complexity that creates got TypeScript to say, absolutely not, right? And so you are somewhat limited. You could say that it is like six, you could say that's a hashtag, a string that starts with a hashtag. You could say that it's this, and it could be any number. You're still somewhat limited, but where this is really useful is like, you saw like those action types I was creating. Like what I could do, see how this is like update hex color, update RGB color, right? I could say that like is, so let's say we had color formats, I don't know. And we said it was RGB hex HSL HSV, right? I think those are the ones I have. What I could do is say that my valid action types are, and I use this all the time in actions. If you look at this, it is now all of those made on the fly for me, right? So I don't have to type them all. The camera can't see the faces facing me, but I can see them. Yeah, some of the like power and convenience. So like for like a lot of stuff, like if you're like getting a resource and it's like requested, loaded, error, or loading, you can like automatically have these templates that you're kind of using and like generate a bunch of these string types automatically. And like particularly actually in this use case, I use this a lot, right? I will use it for like all sorts of different statuses and stuff along those lines where I can expect something. So like something like this, is super useful. Now the problem is, like we saw with our, like we have value as number. However, like nothing, this type that I made, like those color inputs are not gonna give me this type, right? And so you would have to write something like this to check it all the time. So this is why we're not totally gonna go all the way down this road, but I do wanna tell you that this road exists. And so we could do like is hex color, and we'll take some string, right? So we want to insist it's a string in the very beginning. And I can say return starts with a hash, which is really the only thing that makes this true. And then if this is a Boolean return, right? Normally, right? It's a returns a Boolean. What I can do is say, and it's basically TypeScript is saying, if you validate that this is the right type, I will believe you, right? And so if it's like, yo, that string, which totally had a hashtag at the beginning, right? This just says it's a string because of the type system. I don't really know. You can write this logic, and now if something goes in, right, it will tell you that this is the actual type that you want to use, right? And so you can like say like, hey, TypeScript's like, I'm not sure. You're like, let me check. It is, and they'll be like, okay, cool, cool, cool. This is a hex color. I'll treat it like that from now on. Super, super powerful. I use this like especially when getting JSON data back from APIs, right, where it could be anything. And I want to insist as a certain type throughout my code base. When I get that API request back in, I will do a bunch of these checks and cast it to the correct type based on these like super unit tested. You know, this is a powerful tool. So if you just like, if this returns true, I can cast anything I want to anything, right? But I can go ahead, and if I really don't know what something is, like if it could be an array or it could be a string or something like that, that's where unknown comes in, where it makes no assumptions. You figure out everything in the Thunderdome over here, and then like whatever comes out will be the type that it uses. Did anyone see the bad thing that I did that I hid in there for you to find? It's the same bad thing I keep hiding everywhere, so like, yeah, let's look at the context. Oh yeah, like right. I think maybe I'll stop the editor. Right.
I found it.
What?
Any.
Right. Like, which means that this can be any. Which means update. Like, can go. Like, who knows the ways this can mess me up. But this creates a somewhat like interesting like problem, which is like, so the way that update works is it takes an object that has the keys available in an object, and then it just kind of replaces the current ones, right? If I turn this into item, well, that's going to be problematic because theoretically, I also have to change it here. Like, yo, I fixed it in my actual implementation, but you know why I'm not blowing up? Because they spread. Oh, look, now it's angry at me. Like one any. All it takes is one any. Like you saw it with my action earlier. And the way this works is like we're only replacing one property, right? Over here, we're just taking like whatever. We're taking the name. We're just replacing the name. We're just replacing pact, right? And so I want the situation where any keys you give me better be on item. But I don't need all of them, right? I don't want to replace the ID of an item. What kind of person would do that? I just want to say, like, optionally, I want to be able to replace anything on an item, right? And this is where utility types, which are just pure TypeScript, come in helpful, but in a very like specific React use case. So like, what would this look like? So let's go back into our context. And you might say that, hey, Steve, if you had like magically derived this, or if you're using use dispatch, you wouldn't have to do this in two places. Yeah, agreed. But this is the point, was to see it with use state and some of the trade-offs. So one of the things I could do is say partial. What partial does, partial is a utility method, right? You can kind of, you can see it by hovering over it. And like, if that stresses you out, that's OK. It stresses me out. But basically, it takes all the keys in the object and makes them all optional. It's basically like taking everything and dynamically putting a question mark in front of all of them. It's built into TypeScript. I didn't have to do anything. I didn't have to write it. It's been there for a while. New versions of TypeScript very frequently have more and more of these. There's a one that I really like that came out. It's either coming out in 4.9 or it came out in 4.8. I think it's coming out 4.9, which is awaited, which is if you use await, it's like this is either the promise that we're awaiting or it's the value, and it just does all of that for you. Because previously, I think even when we did like a previous version of this course, like figuring out whether or not something was a promise, you had to like check for a then method and stuff like that. It was not easy, and there's been a lot of abstractions that make that a lot better. I have like a custom one in my code base that I hate, and I am waiting until we upgrade to 4.9. Yeah, that's what it is, before I can use it. So this makes them all optional. But what if you wanted to say, all of them optional, but I better not see an ID in there, right? This is where more utility types come in handy. So we could say like omit, and if I just put around item, it would just take it out of item, but this is omitting it out of the partial one, right? So I can say omit, and I can say ID. And if I grab this real quick, we can see, kind of break it out so we can just hover over and see. So we'll say partial item. We'll just grab that first part. And then we'll say type parial partial. Omit. This is a great way to like not retype stuff all over the place. Partial item. And then like, but don't include the ID. So if you look at partial item, that is now, these can all be either string or undefined versus the regular item, which was, that was not the case for. They all had to be there. And without ID says, but not the ID, right?